Elite Facts presents
Random and Dark Facts About the Ancient Egyptians. 8. King Tut was possibly killed by a hippo. We all know of King Tut. He's one of the first things we think about when it comes to ancient Egypt, besides pyramids and the desert. Tutankhamun was the Egyptian pharaoh, who's more commonly referred to as King Tut. Since there are no records or even stories passed down through the generations of his death, this topic has been the subject of considerable debate. Though there is some speculation that he might even have been assassinated, in 2005, a CT scan taken of King Tut's mummified remains revealed that he had suffered a leg fracture and that the leg had become infected. Other theories suggest that the cause of Tut's death was a combination of malaria and Kohler disease too, or that he died of sickle cell disease. Scans of King Tut's body show that he was embalmed without his heart or chest wall, which is weird because it's against traditional Egyptian burial practice. Surprisingly, some Egyptologists believe that King Tut's death was caused by a hippopotamus. The reason for this being that the ancient Egyptians hunted hippopotamus for sport, and statues found in King Tut's tomb even depict him in the act of throwing a harpoon. Hippos are known to attack and kill. Some Egyptologists believe that his death might have been the result of a hunt gone wrong.
7.
The living shared food with the dead. If we're being perfectly honest, for the most part, we have never seen a civilization that treats the dead with more respect than the ancient Egyptians. Regardless of whether or not they were able to put their loved ones into a sarcophagus, they tried their best to preserve their family's bodies. So respectful, in fact, that they would actually try and attempt to feed the dead. Back then, there were tombs that were designed as an eternal home for the mummified body and the Ka spirit that lived beside it. An accessible tomb chapel allowed families, well-wishers, and priests to visit the deceased and leave the regular offerings that the Ka required, while a hidden burial chamber protected the mummy from harm. Within the tomb chapel, food and drink were offered on a regular basis. The reasoning behind this was because these bodies had been spiritually consumed by the Ka. They were then physically consumed by the living. During the Feast of the Valley, an annual festival of death and renewal, many families spent the night in the tomb chapels of their ancestors. The hours of darkness were spent drinking and feasting by torchlight as the living celebrated their reunion with the dead. Granted, this is a bit creepy, but it's kind of touching in a way to see so much respect given to the deceased.
6.
Cleopatra was not Egyptian. Along with both Ramses and King Tut, perhaps no figure is more famously associated with ancient Egypt than Cleopatra VII. That being said, however, it's kind of strange that she wasn't even Egyptian. Cleopatra was actually part of a long line of Greek Macedonians originally descended from Ptolemy I, one of Alexander the Great's most trusted lieutenants. The Ptolemaic dynasty ruled Egypt from 323 BC to 30 BC, and most of its leaders remained largely Greek in their culture and sensibilities. In fact, Cleopatra was infamous for being one of the first members of the Ptolemaic dynasty to actually speak fluent Egyptian. Now that's impressive.
5.
Ancient Egyptians believed in more than 2,000 deities. So when it came to the ancient Egyptians, modern society believed that they worshipped two things, one being their current pharaoh, and the other thing being the Egyptian god Ra. Or was it the god Isis? Anubis, maybe? Well, they're all correct. In fact, the ancient Egyptians believed in over 2,000 deities. The reason for this was because the Egyptians worshipped different gods so that life could be kept in balance. Each god had different responsibilities. The list of deities included the hawk-headed sun god Ra, the goddess of moisture Tefnut, Anubis, the god of embalming and the dead, and many, many more.
4.
Mummification process. Probably one of the most well-known traditions from ancient Egyptian civilization is the mummification process. So when a body was mummified, the brain was usually removed through one of the person's nostrils and was usually removed with other internal organs like the intestines, liver, stomach, and lungs, among other things. And these organs are then stored in jars called canopic jars. Each organ was placed in its own jar. The only internal organ that was not removed was the heart, because Egyptians considered it to be the seat of the soul. Originally, the earliest ancient Egyptians buried their dead in small pits in the desert. The heat and dryness of the sand dehydrated the bodies quickly, creating lifelike and natural mummies. Later, the ancient Egyptians began burying their dead in coffins to protect them from wild animals in the desert. Even with this method, however, they realized that bodies placed in coffins would decay when they were not directly exposed to the hot, dry sand of the desert. Over many centuries, the ancient Egyptians developed a method of preserving bodies so that they would remain lifelike. The process included embalming the bodies and wrapping them in strips of linen. Today, we call this process mummification.
3.
The ancient Egyptians forged one of the earliest peace treaties on record. So, who would have honestly thought that the Egyptians created one of the earliest known peace treaties on record? For over two centuries, the Egyptians fought against the Hittite Empire for control of lands in modern-day Syria. This conflict gave rise to bloody battles like 1274 BC's Battle of Kadesh, but by the time of the pharaoh Ramses II, neither side had emerged as a clear victor. In 1259 BC, with both the Egyptians and Hittites facing threats from outsiders, Ramses II and the Hittite king Hattusili III decided to bury the hatchet, and they negotiated a famous peace treaty. This agreement ended the conflict and decreed that the two kingdoms would aid each other in the event of an invasion by a third party. The Egyptian-Hittite treaty is now recognized as one of the earliest surviving peace accords, and a copy can even be seen above the entrance to the United Nations Security Council chamber in New York.
2.
Egyptian workers were known to organize labor strikes. Who says unions didn't exist in the 12th century BC? So as it turns out, even though they regarded the pharaoh as kind of a living god, Egyptian workers were not afraid to protest for better working conditions. Considering the work they would undertake, can you honestly blame them for forming a union? The most famous example came in the 12th century BC during the reign of the new kingdom pharaoh Ramses III. When laborers engaged in building the royal necropolis at Deir el-Medina did not receive their usual payment of grain, they organized one of the first recorded strikes in history. The protest took the form of a sit-in. The workers simply entered nearby mortuary temples and refused to leave until their grievances were heard.
1.
The pyramids were not built by slaves. We're finishing up this list with one of the biggest aspects of ancient Egypt, the pyramids and the workers who built them. Needless to say, the life of a pyramid builder certainly wasn't an easy one, that's for certain. Skeletons of these workers commonly show signs of arthritis and other ailments such as back problems. That being said, however, these remains also showed significant evidence that suggests that the massive tombs were built not by slaves, but by paid laborers. These ancient construction workers were a mix of skilled artisans and temporary hands, and some appear to have taken great pride in their craft. Other signs of this are shown through graffiti found near the monuments, which suggest that they would often assign humorous names to their crews, like the Drunkards of Menkaure or the Friends of Khufu. Now, if these people were slaves, they sounded like pretty happy slaves if they could joke around like that. The idea that slaves built the pyramids at the crack of a whip was first conjured up by the Greek historian Herodotus in the 5th century BC, but most historians now dismiss it as myth. While the ancient Egyptians were certainly not averse to keeping slaves, they appear to have mostly used them as field hands and domestic servants. Can you think of any interesting facts we may have missed? If so, share them with us in the comments below. And thanks for watching.
Don't forget to like us and subscribe for more Elite Facts.